Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you digital TV transmitter and digital TV receiver in this session. So to explain this session based on digital TV transmitter and digital TV receiver, these are my session outlines.
So first, I'll be explaining basics of digital TV transmitter and receiver. After that, I'll cover different components which is there in digital TV transmitter and receiver, and in parallel with that we will see block diagram and working of digital TV transmitter and receiver. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of digital TV transmitter. So when we talk about digital transmitter, this digital TV transmitter transmits different programs which we observe on our television, and there are multiple programs that has been transmitted by digital TV transmitter. So digital TV transmitter is not only sending single program at a time, it is sending multiple programs at a single time. So first I'll explain you, one program is being transmitted by digital TV transmitter, and then after multiple programs how it is getting multiplexed, that is what we will discuss. So see, in digital TV signal transmission, we can subdivide that into three parts. One is digitization, second is digital compression, and third is channel encoding. Now see, in digitization, we are converting analog signal into digital signal, and here in analog to digital converter, there are this process. First we do sampling, then quantization, and then encoding. In sampling, we convert analog signal into discrete signal, and in quantization, we convert analog signal into discrete with discrete amplitude, and after that, to this discrete amplitude, we give digital data by having encoding process. In digital compression, we are a little bit to compress video and audio. So for video, we have MPEG encoder to have digital video compression, and in audio data compression, we do non-linear quantization. So there is compounding technique that we use it for audio compression. I have already made session in digital communication based on non-linear quantization, where I have explained A low and mu low. So that we can use it to compress audio signal. And in channel encoding, we have forward error correction and modulation. So this is what the complete process which we have it in digital TV transmitter. Now let us see different components step by step, so it will be more clear. See, for one channel, we will discuss this first. So here one program is happening that is having video data, and that data is being recorded by TV camera, and audio of that data that is being received by this mic. So over this side we will be having video data, and over this side we will be having analog electrical signal. Now see, in TV camera, at output side of TV, there will be three different formats which is possible. One is YUV, second is YIQ, and third is YCBCR. When we talk about YUV format, so in that Y is luminance signal, U and V that is chrominance signal, and Y is equals to 0.299R plus 0.587G plus 0.114B. So this is what luminance data, and U that will be 0.492B minus Y, and V that is 0.877R minus Y. So that is what YUV data, where Y is luminance and U and V is chrominance signals. And in case of YCBCR, you will be having Y that is luminance signal again, and CB that is B minus Y, and CR that is R minus Y signal. And In YIQ, Y is luminance and I and Q, those are chrominance data. So that is how three formats are available. Here in digital TV transmission, we use YUV data only. In NTSC PAL system, you will be finding YUV data is being transmitted. So here I am writing YUV data, where Y is luminance and U and V is chrominance of data. And over here audio signal, that will be very weak signal. So here there will be amplifier over here after reception of audio signal by mic. And this is what we are giving it to analog to digital converter, where by this analog to digital converter, we are first doing sampling process, that is to discretize continuous signal, and then after there will be quantization, where we provide discrete amplitude, and after quantization there will be encoding, where we'll be giving digital value to discrete amplitude. So sampling, quantization and encoding will result into analog to digital converter. And then after, this is what digitization of one program. And then after, we give it to video and audio compression. In video compression, there will be MPEG coding, and in audio compression, we can use compounding technique, where we can have non-linear quantization for compounding. So there are two basic laws which is available, A law and mu law for compounding. So that we can use it for audio compression. And this is what about one program. And this one program that we give it to multiplexer. Why? The reason is at TV transmitter there could be multiple programs. So you can see multiple programs are multiplexed here, and that will be generating one signal, and this is what compression. And after that there will be forward error correction, that is to send data digitally, and it is possible at in channel there could be more noise which will generate error. So for that correction, we have forward error correction block over here. After that there can be modulator. Here modulator is been utilized with different techniques. For HD TV broadcasting, we can have QPSK modulator over here. And after that, we are sending it by antenna over here, or one can say there can be digital broadcasting by cable. So this is what about channel encoder. So this complete block diagram explains multiple program that could be transmitted by antenna, and this is what the complete process. Now let us see basics of digital TV receiver. So digital TV signal receiver, that can be again subdivided into three parts. First is channel decoding, where we do demodulation of received signal and error detection and correction is happening. And in digital decompression, we need to do video and audio decompression. MPEG decoder will decompress digital video, and expanding for non-linear quantization will decompress audio signal. And then we have analog conversion over here, and that analog signal that we give it to TV display for video, and for audio we give it to speaker. So this is what about TV digital TV receiver. Now let us see it by different components, so it will be a bit more clear. Now see, first of all we have antenna which will receive signal, that we give it to demodulator. For HD TV there will be QPSK demodulator over here. Then after there will be channel decoder block. So this will be correcting digital error which is happening in channel, and this complete process is referred as channel decoder. After that there will be demultiplexer, that will demultiplex channel. Whatever channel is been selected by remote control of television, it will be selecting that particular channel. So for example, if I say channel number 1 is getting selected by remote control of TV, here demultiplexer that will select program number 1. Now for that program number 1, over here there will be video decompression and audio decompression. For video decompression there will be MPEG decoder, and for audio decompression there will be non-linear dequantization, where we do expanding process of audio, and this is what decompression, and after that we provide digital to analog conversion. So here there will be analog video signal, and over here there will be analog audio signal. After that analog audio signal, we can connect amplifier to give this to speaker, and over here in audio signal of, sorry, analog signal of video signal, there will be YUV signal, and that we translate into RGB to display that on TV. So this is how we have complete process at receiver side to display any program on television with audio.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.